car is having strange electrical problems, then stay tuned. Because today I'm going to show you how to use a simple voltmeter to find electrical problems in your car. Now realize that in your car, the battery supplies both positive power and negative ground power. And many times when weird things happen to your car, like you step on the brakes and the parking light comes on, you have a ground wire problem, which can often be hard to find. Now even I can't see electricity, so you need to test for it. Using this voltmeter, you can find bad grounds quickly. First, hook the meter up to your battery, positive to positive and negative to negative. And in this case, we hit the battery voltage of 12.86, which is normal for a good battery. Now say you want to check to see if the engine is grounded correctly. It's easy. Just take the negative test lead off the battery and then clamp it on something solid like this metal part of the head. And as you can see, it's still exactly 12.86 volts. That means that the engine is perfectly grounded when the engine is shut off. But that's not a good test, really. You want a dynamic test to see if it works when the engine's running. Now, to do that, we have to retest it with the engine running to see what the voltage is with the alternator running, which in this case is 14.26 or 14.27. It keeps moving around. Then we'll take the negative terminal off again and hook it up to the block and see what the reading is. In this case, it's 14.27, so it's good when it's running too. Now, if the reading had been 4/10 of a volt or more in differential, there would be a problem in the grounding wire. But it's the same, so that grounding wire is okay. For instance, if it would have read 13.06 volts, that would have meant it was more than 1 volt less, which would mean there's a problem in the grounding wiring. Now realize that there's ground power wires everywhere in the car, like this one on the back of the firewall here. And you want to test them with the engine off and with the engine on to see if there's a problem either way. And if you find that either one of the readings is 0.4 of a volt or more off, that means there's a problem in that grounding wire and you got to trace the wiring or the connectors at the ends to see if they're corroded or loose. Because if you do have a bad ground wire, when you use that device, it'll often try to draw power from other devices and turn them on. So weird things can happen, like you step on the brakes and the parking lights will come on because it'll start to turn those devices on. When that happens, you almost always have a ground system fault somewhere. Sure, there's grounding wires all over the place, like in the trunk of this Mitsubishi. You can see they run off the lights. But now that you know how to test them with a voltage meter, it's very easy to find out if the grounds aren't working correctly. And I know some of you are going to ask, why do I have to test with the car off and the car on? Well, that's because a weak ground wire might work okay with the car turned off, but when all the power is running through it, if it's got a bad connection or a shorted end on it, it won't take extra power, and you'll see that by a bigger voltage drop, knowing there's a problem. So just like any other machine, it's much better testing them when they're working instead of when they're just sitting there doing nothing. An active dynamic test is much better than a static test, anytime. After all, you want everything to work on a car while you're driving it. You really don't care what it's doing when it's just sitting there resting. So now you know how to do a voltage drop test on grounding systems. Just remember, if you have more than 0.4 of a volt difference, you got a problem in the grounding system. And remember, if you've got any car questions, just visit the Scotty Kilmer channel. And I'll answer them as soon as I'm done drinking some of this moonshine.